The divide between men and women is growing further and further apart. And this is one of the things that our society faces as one of its biggest challenges. Because when men feel they're not acknowledged, not worth something, when they feel ignored by society, the opposite sex, and so on, what do? They turn to finding their identity in archetypes and causes in political movements, ultimately becoming radicalized, dividing further and further. And when women don't feel acknowledged or feel victimized from society or being seen in the wrong way, the same thing happens. And the more that we do that, the more that we rely on seeing the man or woman in front of me as a symbol of what I agree with or disagree with, or something that represents me or something that I'm at war with, we can never find the true fulfillment of what it means to be a man and what it means to be a woman. And this is what we're talking about today, all via message from my IGTV. This one's for you, you know who you are. We're gonna talk about the double standard in society of men being rewarded for their sexual behavior as studs and women being diminished or shamed or whatever you wanna call it as sluts. And if you know me by now, this answer is probably not what you think. And if you really know me by now, the answer is absolutely going to come down to you and your personal empowerment, because if we're going to change society, if we're going to change the world around us, we have to be rock solid with the world within us first. Hey guys, my name is Steve Maeda and I'm a men's coach in Austin, Texas. I'm a BJJ practitioner, a Wim Hof enthusiast. I have an amazing family, four awesome boys and a beautiful wife. And what this podcast is about being the better man. What we talk about is tried and true because we've been doing it with groups of men just like you for over 12 years. Listen up, and I hope you enjoy. So one of the fundamental things when it comes down to men and women is we need to start communicating around one another more. What actually completes us, what makes us more of a man or more of a woman and truly within ourselves, is integrating together. Now that doesn't deny the fact that we need to have women's groups, men's groups, or friends or whatever that have a divide. But ultimately, what completes us as a sex and what gives us our purpose biologically, emotionally, psychologically, and in our lifestyle is when we come together. And this is an overall rule for everything, is that yes, we have division amongst us, we're all different in so many ways, but fundamentally, we have to be able to work together. So now to answer this question, sluts versus studs, studs versus sluts. Is society somehow labeled this? And see, here's the problem with this, is anybody who's been sexually active or really explored sex as much as I have, for better or for worse, we realize how ridiculous this thing is. We realize that there's a flaw on multiple angles and sides of this. We have one side which comes perhaps from feminism, which is saying that society has empowered this, it has shaped this, and part of that is absolutely true, but not all of it. And then we have, you know, the men's rights movement and so on and all these other men's groups saying that men are biologically predispositioned to spread their seed and act in this way, and it moves into the emotions of women and men, and this is science and so on. In fact, both sides of this are saying that it's science, that it is an absolute, so much to the point where it's an absolute where we don't need to listen to one another. And whereas I agree with both of those things, I disagree with their interpretations of them completely. Meaning that yes, I believe that society absolutely influences men and women and their sex lives. But society can never override what is biologically within us. And also, I believe that biology shapes us, that we can't really run from sex, that our identities as men and women are within a boundary of what man and woman is. But I also don't think that that means that men get to be dickheads or just misogynistic assholes. What I actually think is neither of the groups are going into their nature of what they are. And the best way to get into our nature isn't following some template of sex or template of this is how to be a man, this is how to be a woman. And so how do we get back to our nature? Is it a template I can give you? Is it a recipe of how to be a man or how to be a woman or what men and women are absolutely like that we strive for? That's exactly what I think is screwing us up. Within our DNA, within who we are as biological beings, it is so powerful for the man and woman to come out if we start socializing, empathizing, and feeling one another rather than fearing one another. And this kind of goes back to that culture war video that I put out the other day, is that the more that we rely on a side to define us, the more that we have to take a side, the more that we have to take a stance, it takes us out of our personal interactions with people. What's so interesting about this is my friend that messaged me this is a feminist. She's somebody that's part of a, I guess, political identity that I'm not a part of. But that doesn't mean I can't be friends with her. That doesn't mean that I can't listen to her. That doesn't mean that I can't respect what she thinks and feels. That why she thinks what she thinks and does what she does is far deeper than the label that I can see on the surface. But that also doesn't mean that if I talk to her about this, that it harms me, that I need to hate her, that I need to divide from her. And what is so important about all of this is that the two of us talking isn't going to affect either side. And man, I don't even know what side I'm on, but I'd probably be on the man's side. I'd probably be seen more on the misogynistic side. I don't think I'd be a feminist, at least in the terms of what we hear extreme feminism is all about. Anyway, whatever, whatever. The fact is that there's a lot of different people that we talk to. Now, I do think, and I just think this, and I'm no scientist or expert, but I have had a tremendous amount of sexual experience, and I've also coached people on it. And now, mind you, I've coached mainly men, but I have worked with women a little bit, but a tremendous amount of experience with men. That feeling of being objectified sexually does happen to men, and I do think that men and women are very different in this and how that sort of social shame sits on it. But in addition to that, I also think that society takes advantage of that biological lean. So just to explain, what I actually think is that men can feel shame, women feel it in a little bit of a different way. Men also feel empowered sexually in a very braggadocious way and a personal way, but women feel it in a very personal way as well. And I agree that we can feel all of those traits, but generally we kind of move in those different directions. And when that happens, we have a society that doesn't really see sex as something to talk about, but sees it more as a commodity or something that we talk about in terms of emotional hysteria or some emergency or some way that it's harmed us or this is going to be the solution, rather than seeing it as this really normal thing that sex is more natural for us to be doing, yet we make it this thing that in order to talk about it, it has to have harmed us or have some big emergency. And this goes back to that divide of men and women that we were talking about in the beginning of this video, is that the more that we take something that's very, very natural, that's an expression that we can't get rid of, that we're all gonna do, we're all gonna mess up, we're all gonna be clunky about, we're all gonna get wrong and we're all gonna get right. Well, hopefully we all get it right. The more that we put that in a box and the more that we try and control it, the more that we try and define it by a society which does so many unnatural things, which are good things. Like, don't get me wrong, I like driving, I like reading. But we didn't really evolve to do those things. It just so happens that we're capable of doing those things. But the more that we try and define something that is absolutely natural in a world and a template that is unnatural, that's where we polarize. That's where we lose our identity. That's where we stop feeling like a man or we stop feeling like a woman. And that when we get divorced or go through a tough time, we think that, you know, women are set out to manipulate us and feminism has taken over the world and is the biggest cancer, or that the patriarchy is destroying us. And don't get me wrong, there are absolutely problems. There are problems. But in order for us to fix that, we need to fix ourselves. And in order for us to fix ourselves, we need to stop fighting the war within ourselves, or stop fighting the war that is 1,000 miles away that will never end, that we can always distract ourselves with and make peace within ourselves. I mean, look, my whole life is being a men's coach, working with men, and hopefully that does have a bigger impact than just the men that I help. But man, I'm happy with it, helping one man at a time for thousands and thousands of guys for 12 years. But if I were to expect that somehow I would radically change society or whatever, or change you, who isn't really asking for my help, that means that I would need to force something upon you. And when we have a force of nature within us, like sex, like socializing, like connecting, like being a real person and expressing, when I try and force that force of nature, it breaks something. And man, there's no celebration in that force breaking me, you, a powerful friendship, or a happy sex life that you're taking yourself away from. So yeah, men and women need to talk. They need to talk a lot, and they need to realize that the answer is in that sort of talking. And they need to realize that the answer is in really hearing and taking seriously both sides. And the more that we think that our side is an absolute and that science backs us, so much to the point where we don't need to acknowledge the other side, well, we already have enough of that. We don't need that. And that's what we need to stop.
Hey-ya!